And the first thing we're going to hear is actually, it's the only thing on the program that's not actually an early music tune. It's actually a Breton folk dance. But as with most folk music, it has its origins that go back centuries, so I feel perfectly justified in putting this on the program. The instrument that you're going to hear is called a hurdy-gurdy. And the hurdy-gurdy is basically, it's a stringed instrument, and it gets its sound by having a wheel that turns against however many strings the instrument has. This one has, what, six, eight, 13? six strings. And the wheel acts like a bow, like a violin bow, except that it just goes all the time. And then there are keys on the instrument that actually enables the performer to play the notes. They are extremely temperamental instruments, which we hope we will not demonstrate to you today, but you never know. But this is Paul Neidhart, and he's going to play a solo on her. It's a medieval dance. student on and on, very few of them have actually survived to come down to us. The two that we'll be playing today, this one and one that we'll play later, come from a manuscript that was discovered. It was written in the early 1400s, but it includes music that is actually much older than that. And the person that copied it down apparently did so very hurriedly because it's full of mistakes that modern editors have had to figure out, well, did he mean to do this, or was this just a mistake that the copy has made? We really don't know, so we have to guess. But I'm just going to say that any bad notes that you hear tonight are the copy's fault. This is Lamento di Trista.
Thank you.
you so from the Las Vegas Codes.
Thank you.
These would have been dances that would be very popular in any of the Renaissance courts anywhere in Europe. And my favorite girl is trying to roll down the aisle. We don't want that. So these would have been popular. The musicians of the time would have had to play these over and over and over and over again to accommodate the dancers, because typically the pieces are very short. We're not going to do that today, because if you don't have dancers to watch, you can get little pieces after 5 or 6 or 9 or 14 repetitions. But we're going to give you just a little taste of what these dances would have sounded like. And we'll let you imagine, what the dancers would look like. You will hear at the end of several of these pieces, when the dance stops, we'll play an extended chord. That would be where the dancers would turn and face each other and bow or curtsy. So just let your imagination wander and think of the dancers. Unfortunately, we don't have any to actually show you, but you can at least hear what the dance is. Thank you.